He already had Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Jamal Wilkes. But when he got Magic, that really set the tone for the full definition of what Showtime was all about.
What's up, Africa? It's your boy, Jimmy, and this is NBA Africa Game Time. Now, over the past couple of weeks, we've had the opportunity to speak with legends from the NBA, and we'll be bringing those interviews to you, the fans, right here on our NBA Africa YouTube page. Having said that, it's showtime. That's the best way to describe our guest today. He's one of the greatest Lakers ever. Now, going by his nickname, Big Game James, you already know we're talking about the 7-time All-Star and a 3-time champion, the Hall of Famer, the one and only, James Worthy.
The Hawks with 2-0-1. Oh!
All right, first question, Big Game James. Now, you spent your entire career with the Lakers. Can you talk to us about what makes the Lakers organization so special, and what do you think is the reason why it still has such a huge fan base around the world?
Well, I think it started with Dr. Buss. You know, when he purchased it from Kent Cook, and he had a vision as a Laker fan his whole life. He wanted to be innovative, and he was. And he hired people like Jerry West and Bill Sharman, and he allowed them to do their job. He didn't get in the way. He trusted them, and that was good teamwork. He also knew how to brand his team. He lived in Hollywood. You weren't going to get that anywhere else. Dr. Buss was the one who started floor seats. No one else was putting seats on the floors. Laker girl. Nobody had cheerleaders. He had all of that. He already had Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Jamal Wilkes. But when he got Magic, that really set the tone for the full definition of what Showtime was all about. It was flashy, it was Hollywood, it was everything.
McGee backpedaling, the ball out in front, stolen by James Worthy. You can forget a slam dunk.
Oh, he put a little fancy
move. He rocked the baby to sleep and then put it up two-handed slam.
All right, Big Game, talk to us about how it felt to be picked number one in the draft. What were the expectations and the pressures you faced? And of course, please give any advice you can to the future number one picks that are going to be handling the same expectations and pressures.
The Lakers won a championship in 1982. Fortunately for me, Cleveland fell fast to the bottom. And so when 1982 came around, the Lakers had their number one draft pick. The rule was the team that had the number one draft pick, which was the Lakers, and the team that had the worst record, which was the Clippers, tossed a coin to see who got the number one draft pick. Just so happened, the Lakers won, and that's how I ended up being a Laker.
For the first pick, he's 6'9", 225 pounds from North Carolina, James Worthy.
The pressure of being the number one draft pick is huge because you're expected to turn, in most cases, the worst team around. Well, the Lakers were already successful. They already had won 2 championships. So it was kind of a blessing in disguise, but it's a lot of pressure because the eyes are on you to perform. I haven't given any personal advice, but the advice I generally give, it's just a different monster. It's not like it was in college. You're playing against great players every night. You double or triple the amount of games. Take care of your body. And most importantly, make sure you get a good tax return.
Now, which player in the league currently reminds you of yourself?
I don't know, man. I mean, I was a slasher, fast break guy. I didn't develop the outside shot until later in my career and never really shot the three. So it's hard to, you know, look at players. You know, when I look at slashers, when I look at how Durant gets to the cup sometime, even though he's 6'11", when I look at how he slashes to the cup sometime, I like that. Paul George, when he gets, you know, in that 8-foot range, when he can pull up for that little quick jumper, I had that. You don't see too many players play with their back to the basket anymore like I did, and spin moves and things like that. So it's hard to compare, but, you know, I like those players who can get to that 10-foot area and operate and finish on the break, that kind of thing.
Cooper, a great pass to Worthy. A 3-pointer, good!
James, congratulations on being the MVP of this series.
Yes! We go through it just like they do!
I'd like to say a big thank you to Mr. James Worthy for taking time out to join us right here on NBA Africa Game Time. Now, of course, if you're looking for more exclusive content, you can check us out on our social media pages, talking about Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and our Instagram page, which is NBA Africa Official. I am Jimmy saying, till we meet again, peace, love, much respect. Bye for now.